Mr. Tarrou, we're going to take a look today. We're going to continue our discussion about graphing linear equations, linear functions. And we're going to do it now instead of using slope-intercept form, which is y equals mx plus b. Really nice form because we can draw a graph just by looking at the equation. But what if we have an equation in standard form and we don't feel like setting it equal to y? Or, of course, your teacher just says, hey, I want you to graph using x and y intercepts. Let's take this equation, 3x plus 7y equals 21. That equation is in standard form. Now, what standard form is, I'll erase this in a minute, but standard form is when an equation has, and again, we're talking linear equations, so all the exponents are 1, and it's ax plus by equals c. And a, b, and c are all integers. And some textbooks will even tell you that the coefficient of x will have to be positive. Most textbooks I've seen have written that in there. The last one I looked at didn't. But standard form is when you have the equation, here's the equal sign, the x and the y's are on the left-hand side, and the coefficients that you have in here, almost every textbook I've ever seen will say that those must be integers. No decimals or fractions are allowed. So, here we have an equation in standard form. And really for graphing, I don't really care so much that it's standard form. I just note that the y is not alone. If y was isolated, then we could just use the slope and the y-intercept because it would probably be in standard slope-intercept form or very close. But this one's not. So how do you find an x-intercept? Well, you know, think of that's where the graph crosses the x-axis. Well, if you touch a point on the x-axis, name off the coordinate. That's 3, 0. Here's a point on the x-axis. That's negative 5, 0. Here's another point. I don't know what that x-coordinate is, but I do know the y-coordinate is going to be 0. If you have a line coming through and crossing the x-axis, that is an x-intercept. If you're on the x-axis, the y has to be 0. So, if you want an x-intercept, just take your equation, even if it is in slope-intercept form, and it doesn't even matter what kind of equation it is, you might be graphing something to the fourth degree. If you plug in y equals 0, you will find an x-intercept. These are just linear functions, though, so we have 3x plus 7 times 0 equals 21. 7 times 0 is 0, and when you add by 0, nothing changes, so now I don't need to write that. 3x equals 21, and when I divide by 3, I get x is equal to 7. So this line has a y-intercept, or x-intercept, at 7. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now let's take a look at finding a y-intercept. Well, if you don't already know how to find a y-intercept, just think about it. You have a line coming through here, and I don't know if this line is going to go up or down, but you have a line coming through and you're crossing the y-axis. Well, if you're on the y-axis, what's the x-coordinate have to be? Well, this coordinate is 0, 4. This coordinate is 0, 1. This coordinate is 0, negative 3, 0, negative 5, 0, negative 9. If I am touching the y-axis, there has been no left or right movement from the origin, so the x has to be 0. So, for an x-intercept, for a y-intercept, you let x equal 0. Plug it into your equation, 3 times 0 plus 7y equals 21, 7y equals 21, divide both sides by 7, and you get y is equal to 3. So, what's that? Anyway, looks like a muffin. This equation is going to cross the x-axis at 7. This equation, this linear equation with exponents of 1, are going to cross the y-axis at 3. And there we go. There's our line. Not too bad. I was going to say something else and just forgot. Okay, so that's the line. Oh, you only need 2 points to define a line. A line slope never changes. So two points are sufficient for graphing a line, and that's what we have in an x and y intercept. One more example. Let's take a look at negative 5x plus 2y equals 12. All right, x-intercept. Remember what that is? Y equals 0. So for an x-intercept, we're going to let y equal 0 and get negative 5 plus 2 times, see I'm taking the y out and replacing it with 0, equals 12. And we get negative 5x, after that cancels out, equals 12. Divide both sides by negative 5. And x is equal to, okay, how many 5s are in 12? That's 5 times 2 is 10, so it's negative 2. And 12 minus 10 is 2, so the remainder is 2, and we're dividing by 5, so it's negative 2 and 2 fifths. Well, that's great if your teachers are reinforcing fractions, but that's not so great for graphing. Like, where is 2 fifths? Well, 2 divided by 5 is 0.4, so x equals negative 2.4, and that's going to be our x-intercept. So 0, negative 1, negative 2, and I don't want to go to negative 3, it's somewhere in the middle. So that's that x-intercept. What about the y-intercept? Well, if you set y equal to 0 for the x-intercept, you let x equal 0 for the y-intercept. So y-intercept is when x equals 0, and well, that's negative 5 times 0 for x plus 2y equals 12. 2y equals 12 because multiplying by 5 or multiplying by 0 gives you 0, and again, when you add by 0, nothing happens, so we don't need to write it. And you undo multiplication with division. We're trying to solve for y. We're trying to get 2 away from y to the other side. The opposite of multiplication is dividing. So we divide both sides by 2, and y equals 6. Okay, so this now blue equation is crossing the x-axis at negative 2. It's crossing the y-axis at 6. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And voila. Whoops, I missed a little bit there. We have another line. And if you were solving a systems of equations, that might be coming up soon in your algebra book, solving a systems of equations is finding out where those two lines cross. That looks like it's about negative 1, 3.5, but that's just a guesstimate, and I'm sure it's not exactly right. And even though I said this section was graphing by x and y intercepts, so let me just remind you that if you're solving an equation that has, or excuse me, not solving, graphing an equation only has one variable, such as x equals, oh, let's say x equals negative 2. X equals negative 2, I just said in the last video, and if you don't remember, pick a couple of x values or pick a couple of points that have x values of negative 2. That's going to be a vertical line through x equals negative 2. If you are asked to graph the line y equals negative 4, y equals a number is a horizontal line. So just go to where y equals negative 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, and draw that horizontal line one more time. If you don't remember that y equals a number is horizontal, just make up a couple of points that have y values of negative 4, and you'll have your graph. All right. So that's graphing linear functions by using x and y intercepts. Woo! Go do your homework.